New at 6, a landmark in San Francisco has become a regular target. Why would someone want to destroy a century-old clock? KPIX 5's Mike Sugerman in San Francisco, and any idea who's in charge of fixing that thing, Mike?
I don't know, Alan. You know, somebody runs it, somebody owns it, somebody fixes it. Everybody sees it, but it's always messed up. What is up with that?
What time do you have?
12:29.
12:29. 12:30. No, I don't see 12. Okay. You know what time it is?
It should be like 12:30.
12:30.
Even a broken clock is right twice a day, but it was wrong three different ways every time I wanted to know.
Is it broken?
Yeah, it's broken.
Why?
Somebody keeps breaking it.
Why is somebody breaking it?
Good question. I couldn't answer for 5-year-old Edward Lazeo.
I've walked by this hundreds of times. I've seen it broken. I can't tell you how many times. In fact, I've never actually seen it completely fixed.
Where are you from?
Philly.
Philadelphia.
Yeah.
This is like our Liberty Bell because it's always broken.
I don't believe this is real. Come on, let's get out of here. Yeah.
What?
Do I not look like a real person?
It's true. This clock is a 20-foot-tall beauty, a timepiece built by master craftsmen.
When was this put here?
It was built in 1915 for Albert Samuels to put in front of his jewelry store, and soon after he died in 1973, it became a city landmark.
It gets vandalized almost every day, every other day, every week.
Keith Ellsbury is an engineer of the flood building next door. The owner of the building has taken a special interest in it, pays for its repairs, which are needed like clockwork.
Street people, the vandalism, they just don't have nothing to do, and that's what they do.
Probably just some young kids. Nothing else to do but vandalize and tag stuff.
There's a whole new meaning to punching the clock. Whatever the case, it's a matter of time before a decision is made what to do with this piece of history and street art. It's a city landmark, but owned by a Los Angeles company which just purchased the property it sits in front of.
It's kind of an ongoing problem. I don't know how we're really going to solve this.
Only time will tell.
You know, that company says it will continue to take care of the clock, but they still haven't figured out how they're going to keep it from getting wrecked all the time. In San Francisco, Mike Sugerman, KPIX 5.